Okay, welcome back to another one of my videos. Welcome back to another great video. So, I'm finished with my breakfast. I'm finished with my workouts. I'm finished watering my plants. I'm finished with our dinner for today. And now all I have to do is fill some orders and I will be finished with those about 3 p.m. But anyway, let's get to this. So I'm back with some more alphabets. But these are the alphabets for rejuvenation. So let's get right into this video. So I'm going to tell you some, once again, I'm going to give you some ailments. The alphabet ailment, and I'm going to give you the herbs that can help you with these ailments. So let's start with, I'm going to tell you what I'm going to give you. First, it's going to be coughs, cramps, and they're in alphabetical order. Coughs, cramps, dandruff, diabetes, dizziness, eczema, epilepsy, eyes, fainting, and fever. Okay. So let's talk about coughs. I'm going to give you some herbs that's great for coughs. Now you can get these herbs in wild-crafted, leafy form, root form, or you can get any of these herbs probably in extracts. Once again, extracts is for when you're actually having that issue. So you would take the extracts as directed on your bottle, or if you get it from me, direct it from me. And you want to take the extracts and just a tiny bit of water, like not even an ounce, with 10 drops of, no, 10 to 30 drops of extract in the water. Okay, so remember, if you buy them in extracts, it's because you're having that problem right now. If you buy an herb form, you're doing it for maintenance. Okay, so let's talk about coughs. So here are the herbs for coughing: black cohosh, coat's foot, comfrey, flaxseed, ginseng, golden seal, red sage, pleurisy, myrrh, lungwort, hyssop, horehound. Let's see what else. Flaxseed, ginseng, and golden seal. I don't know if I said those, but those are the herbs for coughing. Okay. Cramps. These can be any type of cramps. Menstrual cramps. They can be muscle cramps. The first herb is bayberry, blue cohosh, coral, fennel, masterwort, motherwort, pennyroyal, squaw vine, thyme, twin leaf, and wood bentony. Okay, those are herbs for cramping. Let's get into dandruff now. Dandruff, or either alopecia with dandruff, or just a really, really dry, dry scalp. You can use the aloe vera plant, just the plant. And you want to rub it on your scalp, or you can make it as a drink. And you can drink this, the aloe vera. Squeeze a plant in water and down you go. Burdock root, Indian hemp, rosemary, and sage. Now, I would mix all of these probably with some olive oil, all of these for dandruff. Aloe, burdock, root powder, the powder, Indian hemp, rosemary, and sage. I would mix all of them in olive oil and put them on your scalp. That is for dandruff. Diabetes. Let's talk about diabetes. Here are some herbs for diabetes. Bilberry, blue cohosh, gymnia, Gymnia sylvestri, periwinkle, poplar, raspberry leaves, the leaves for this one, and saw palmetto. For dizziness, catnip, peppermint, and the rue, R-U-E, wood bentony, burnet, hopes, fenugreek, garlic, yellow dock, and I want to say pimpernel. I think that one has helped before with dizziness. Yeah, pimpernel. That's P-I-M-P-E-R-N-E-L. Eczema. Eczema, I would say use all of these for eczema in a paste. Calendula, bloodroot, balami, chickweed, golden seal, dandelion root, nettle, plantain, primrose, and yellow dock. You want to get these herbs, as many as you can, or one, but as many of these on this list as you can for eczema. You want to make a paste with manuka honey and a little bit of turmeric. And you want to paste this up real good with manuka honey. Because see, the manuka honey is going to be your antiviral and your bacteria and your antibiotic for eczema, okay? Also, when you make this up as a salve or ointment for your eczema, add a little olive oil with this also. Okay, add a little olive oil with it. And also with this, you can take a spoonful of this, put it in hot water, hot distilled water, and drink this. Because see, you want to kill eczema internally and externally, both. Because eczema starts from the inside. So with this remedy here, you want to kill eczema from the inside to the outside, okay? Epilepsy, frankincense oil. You need frankincense oil, frankincense candles, frankincense incense, and you want to burn them around the house. Frankincense spray them around the house. Certain scents, certain smells trigger the brain. And it causes the body to do certain things in a negative way or a positive way. Frankincense is great for the nervous system. If you use the frankincense oil on the bottom of your feet, behind your ears, a little bit here, and definitely on the wrist, okay? Sprinkle some in your socks, because what happens is the scent from the frankincense oil starts to relax that nervous system that gives you those seizures, okay? I have had people to use frankincense oil and they went from 8 seizures a day down to 3, some down to 4, and eventually it can stop with the correct diet though, okay? We have to stay on this diet. We have to understand that we have to eat to live. Also for epilepsy, black cohosh, elder, ladies slipper, yes, that's a herb, mistletoe, skullcap, valerian root, and vervain, okay? That's for epilepsy. Make them as a tea, 1 cup a day. For our eyes, for your eyes, when you have eye infections or your legally blind or something like that, I'm going to give you some herbs. Bilberry, chamomile, chickweed, hyssop, golden seal, eye bright, slippery elm, rosemary, squavine, and tansy. Those herbs are for your eyes. Let's get into fainting. I went to fainting because I had a client who was just fainting at least 3 times out of a month, and that's way too much. So fainting, cayenne pepper, lavender, motherwort, and peppermint. For fevers, because that's coming, angelica root, bitter root, borage, buckbean, cayenne, cat's claw, catnip, calamus, C-A-L-A-M-U-S, cleavers, dandelion root, echinacea, feverfew, hyssop, Indian hemp, lily of the valley, lobelia, nettle, parsley, poplar, sage, sarsaparilla root, shepherd's purse, sumac berries, S-U-M-A-C berries, tansy, thyme, I'm sorry, thyme, valerian root, vervain, wahoo, W-A-H-O-O, wahoo, willow bark, wintergreen, and yarrow for fevers, okay? So I'm going to come back again later with some more of these alphabets. And the alphabet continues, okay? I try for my videos to be short, but I try for them to give a lot of information in the short video, because I've been watching YouTube for many years now, and I see a lot of videos where people are just babbling on. Babble, 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 blah, 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 and they ain't talking about nothing. So, I don't do those long videos where it's going to be 35, 45 minutes, an hour. It's just so not necessary for what I do. For what I do, it's not necessary. I try to get straight to the point, get to the nitty gritty, tell you what it's all about in the raw. And that's it. Okay. And that's about it. And I will talk to you guys later. If you like this video, like, subscribe, comment, share. Leave me some comments. And let me know something that you guys would want me to go over. Let me know what you want me to talk about, what you want me to go over. Leave it in the comment section. And I'll write it down. And I'll try to do one a day. Okay? If you want to know some herbs for certain ailments, if you want to know whatever, just let me know, because I have way over 10,000. I'm going into like 20,000 now worth of information, products, herbs, you name it. So, like I said, like, subscribe, comment, and share. And let me know in the comments what you want me to talk about, okay? So I will talk to you guys later. See you in the next video. Peace and blessings.